Pipestone Black. It's from Ontario. And it's not a soapstone. This is a few days into it. As you can tell, I got a long ways to go to finish up my detail on this. So here we go. Pipestone came from an island up here in northern Ontario. It's been used traditionally for thousands of years for making pipes. For many years, I supplied all the pipes for many people by giving them stone. Traditionally, you make your own pipes, so I don't make pipes for people. You have to make all of your own. So just recently that I finally decided I was going to do some sculpting. This is my third one after taking a 10-year break. And it's still got a long ways to go. Being so far up north in a small town that the city here has 55,000 people, very hard to find people to carry my works, and I'm not interested in actually selling them here. I'd rather sell them in other places throughout the world. So it's kind of like stuff. We're trying to find somebody that will carry my work. As you can tell, it's very thin right here, all the way around, very thin. The bustles and everything are extremely thin. So I have to be extremely careful. But I need to get as much definition as possible in before I take it to the point of polishing it, and then separating the arms from the body, and finishing the roach up here. So there's a lot more very delicate work I've got to do. And let's see. This piece was originally about this high, this wide, as that it is. The edge of the stone is right here. Touches all the way up. Same on the other side. You go around, you can see the edge of the stone here, but this is the edge of the outside of the stone. This one piece is carved out of that one piece, taking it right directly to the edge of the material. And really push it to the limit. I'm more interested in doing a lot larger pieces. There's not a lot of call for it here in North Bay. Okay, that'll change. I always love people's feedback whenever I can get it, so let me know what you think. Draw anything. I just basically do what I see. see something in the stone I created just by reducing the stone. So this is a First Nation sculpting done by a status First Nations person. So if I do Native art, it's definitely done by a Native person. I'll be posting pictures so that you can see future pieces, and I definitely want to push them a lot further than I'm going to push this one. This should give you a rough idea on how far I'm going to go with this. It's roughly about less than a half inch thick from the back side over here to here. I might bring it in closer, but I'm still debating on whether or not I want to put eagle feathers all the way down the back on here. So I'm thinking it over. And if that's the case, I'm going to need the material. Not only that, it's extremely dangerous as I go further. I don't want to push it too far. Otherwise, there'll be a conversation piece. And that's it. Not too long from now, I'll probably update my website, which I haven't done in, well, I never have done, okay? So, and I really stink when it comes to computers, so hopefully I'll get a company that can do that for me. Down, that's a little better. Mm-hmm. So anyway, I hope you enjoyed seeing the beginning of this. Close to the end, I should say. But I hope you like it. Don't forget, tell me what you think. And I'll definitely keep in touch with people and show you the progress on different pieces. Miigwech. And you have an awesome day. Bye for now.